morning, students. Again, I want to with your proper name, Harsha Rai and Simbu Veeravel, all those students, you have to mention which department you are, and you have to inform your class advisor. Otherwise, how can we identify you to give you attendance? Also, so those who are not able to join in WhatsApp, Google Meet group, please take up the link which is posted in your group, which is a YouTube link. You type your name in the comment box so that we can consider that as a attendance. Please make it.
Okay, once again, very good morning. I welcome you all, students and their faculties and colleagues. Today, the topic of the webinar series is Physics in Everyday Life. Science. It has been proved only by the means of existence and the verification, and only in terms of the physical phenomena as well as the logical axioms. So one of the most kind in order to observation for a human being, it is existence of a physical phenomena and how they are connected between a logical sequence that based on a science foundation. Today we are going to know and recall about what are all the things we have day-to-day life we have used. They are nothing but the science foundation in terms of physics. And now I welcome our department head, Dr. Shalini Pakyam Kamala, to welcome the gathering. Madam, I welcome you, ma'am.
A pleasant morning to you all once again. So we are in the around 28 days of induction program, in which especially particularly for physics we are going to have another session which is given by Dr. Periyasamy on the title Physics in Everyday Life. For this session, I'm happy to welcome the resource person, Dr. Periyasamy, who is assistant professor in the Department of Physics, in Department of Science and Humanities in Nehru Institute of Engineering and Technology. And I'm happy to welcome all my beloved colleagues, and very much happy to welcome all my student friends. Physics in everyday life is the one which we need to observe. As we discuss in our physics classes, everything happening around has its own impact of physics. So I hope sir will share another session which will influence us to observe our surrounding and know the value of science around us. I'm happy to welcome you all again. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now it's my pleasure to introduce our chief guest and one of my faculty, Dr. P. Periyasamy. Sir, he has completed his UG degree in physics from Periyar University, Salem, and he continued his PG degree in Annamalai University
which is an
ancient university in India and well popular across worldwide. Later, he did his MPhil in Priest University and pursued his PhD in Anna University from January 2020. He has worked three Tier 2 engineering colleges for past 9 years and now working as an assistant professor in physics department, NIET. He is an active researcher in energy storage device area and he has total of 8 SCI journals, 3 nationals and national journals and contributed 4 book chapters in his name. Further, he has research collaboration with leading research institutions across India and also in abroad, particularly in Italy and Russia. Now, I welcome our today's chief guest, Dr. Periyasamy, sir. Sir, now the session is yours. I will hand over the session to our chief guest.
Thank you for your nice introduction, sir. Happy morning to all. Here I am Dr. Periyasamy, Assistant Professor of Physics in Department of Physics. Today I am going to present a brief introduction about physics in everyday life. And before going to start that, I want to mention that the philosophy of physics from the life and to the life. Generally, we know that the philosophy, it is a complicated and we need some guidance to understand it. Simply, we can say philosophy, it means it is a conceptual and interpretation. And we know that what does mean conceptual? Conceptual means having some experience with the nature or some phenomena that will trigger ourselves to ask some questions. Why it happens? What is the reason behind of it? So like that questions will arise and they will have some conception and they will try to interpret the whatever they experienced in their own knowledge and they will rectify it and present in the suitable manner. The same way, physics also has some philosophy, just like the general philosophy. So we can simply classify that physics deals with the study of conceptual and the interpretation of matter, energy, and the interpretation between them. We know that what is matter and energy. Matter means it is available in three category: solid, liquid, and gas. And we know what is energy. It is present everywhere, just like your God. So physics, it deals with the interaction between them, how energy is reacting with matter and how it is converted and how we can make it for useful for our society and we can understand how we can understand the basic phenomenon behind of it. So this is the philosophy of physics. And here I have given some famous physicists. The first one is Galileo. We know that he is the very famous person and also origin of the science. He interpreted that the 4 moons of Jupiter and followed by Isaac Newton. We know that with the help of his invention only, gravitational force, we are having now so much of developments in science and technology. And furtherly, his important invention is laws of motion, and followed by Benjamin Franklin, who invented electricity. Now we are having sophisticated electronic equipments, laptop, a cell phone, iPad, electrics and electronic equipments. These items we have. And another one is J.P. Joule.
Hello.
Hello.
Sorry for small intervention. And here I have shown some famous physics. First one is Galileo, and second one is Isaac Newton, and third one is Benjamin Franklin, and who invented electricity, and fourth one is J.P. Joule. He is the background person to understand the nature of heat. And in medical field, we have X-ray generator, that is X-ray, that is invented by William Röntgen. And last one is Albert Einstein. From the name itself, it clearly reveals about his famous and also his contribution to science. He almost touched all the topics in physics, maybe basic mechanism or to advanced nuclear science, particle physics. So without his contribution, the particle physics cannot be developed. And what are their relationship with our real life? Our real life is a multiple dimensional process in both individually or collectively with nature. We are doing some work either in machines or in agriculture work, whatever it may be. We are doing some we are having some connection with the nature by individually or collectively. And there are some more examples about physics in life. Many scientists discovered the physics theory when they are in walking, playing, and so on. I will show you later how they did it. And looking out our life process with the harmony of nature leads to the development of philosophy. This is the famous quote given by Albert Einstein. We have to look over our life process, how it is happens, and how it is relevant to nature, and also by the way, individual or collectively. So we can invent a lot of philosophy. So this is the famous quote given by Albert Einstein. And just to imagine your life without these things. Can you imagine your life without these things? Now, suppose I'm going to collect all your cell phone and put it in bag for one day. What will do? Automatically, present scenario, students, they will go for math. And they will do some unpleasant things. And what about the house appliance, washing machines and bicycles and power transistors, batteries, fan?
Sir, voice is continuously breaking. Sir, voice is continuously breaking.
Madam, can you hear me? Hello? Participants, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Without this invention, we cannot live our sophisticated life. Pressure cooker and the X-ray, CT scan. So these are all the essential for our life, to live a pleasant manner. And emerging philosophy from our real life. I told you that we have some strong connection with nature, either individually or collectively, and some physical phenomenon have invented unexpectedly. For example, Newton discovered gravity when he was sat under an apple tree. We know that who discovered gravity. Obviously, he was thinking about something in his garden under the apple tree. Suddenly, an apple fell on his head. And afterwards, he raised the question, why it was happening? Why all particles, all matters, all objects falling downward directions? Why it should not go upward directions? So repeatedly, he did this experiment. And he concluded that all the particles are, all the matters, all the materials are attracted by ground. Or simply, we can say gravity. And similarly, Archimedes. He is the famous person and who discovered physical law of buoyancy. So this story you may know from your school life. And similarly,
some of the well-known inventors, for example, printing press, lightning rod, light bulbs, telephone, and basketball, fluorescent iPhone, and the World Wide Radio Guidance System. These inventions are invented unexpectedly without any motto. But after invention, it has played a major role in our life, which transformed our life in a sophisticated manner.
And here comes my topic, physics in the human body. This hereafter we will discuss about.
Sir.
Madam.
Sir. Sir, actually, so, sir, Perisamy sir, can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I can hear you.
Madam, I can hear you. Yes, madam, I can hear you. Hello, madam, can you hear me?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes sir, we hear you.
Yes sir.
There was some technical error. Let me briefly review what I have told you briefly. So here I told you that the philosophy, some famous physicist who contributed in much level to the development of science. And what are the relevance with our life? In our real life, we are doing our works individually or collectively with nature. And while we are some works, it may be in a garden, or it may be in an industry, or it may be in a laboratory, they have invented some invention by the physicist. For best example is Newton. He discovered gravity when he was sat under an apple tree. Similarly, Archimedes, who discovered physical law of buoyancy. So these like this event were happened in which are available in Right. Like this event where happens and which are all available in history. And here also some of the famous invention, just like a printing machine, lightning, lightning rod, bulb, fluorescence bulb, iPhone, and the famous one is the World Web, World Wide Website. So these are all the invention which were invented unexpectedly, accidentally, while working in some other work. So similarly, there are also
some more inventions
invented by the physicist or scientist unexpectedly. And hereafter we will look about the applications of physics in a real life. That is human body. Physics in the human body. We know that in our body, it is a mobile laboratory where we can see the mechanics and fluid mechanics, acoustics, haptics, thermodynamics, and electric signals by the way of moving our bones, muscles while doing our work. Mechanism comes into role, and we know that blood is flowing continuously and we are breathing continuously, so fluid mechanics happen, and we can hear the sound and we can reply them, so acoustics comes into role. Similarly, we can view the objects by the way by the help of our eyes, so optics comes into role. And obviously we have some important parameters, that is heat, energy, and pressure. Our body maintains certain temperature and certain energy and certain pressure. If there is any variations in this, we will feel some kind of difficulties, which means our body is not suitable. Similarly, electric signals, we can feel the electric signals. And because the vibrations of the cell membranes, that's why all the signals, suppose if you hit in the leg or any injuries in your body, immediately we can feel it. It may be bottom or head. Immediately we can hear, we can sense it. This is because of all these signals, all the pain, all the feelings are converted into electrical signal and immediately transferred to our brain. That is a supercomputer. So our human body is the mobile laboratory, we can say mobile physics lab. From an engineering perspective, here is some important things. Musculoskeletal system, which is consisting of bones, flesh, nerves, everything. So we have different types of structure. Some people are fatty, some people are medium, some people are medium, very lean. Whatever it may be,
we have some kind of structure, and we have certain mechanisms which have some listening ports in our body that provide balance and motion while we are doing our work, either running or walking or doing some physical exercise, whatever it may be. And another one is cardiovascular system, where we can see the breathing and the pulse are governed by the loss of fluids and pressure. If there is any changes in pressure or breathing or in temperature, immediately we are having some breathing problem and our body will become cold. So here we are having a structure loss. And similarly, brain is a supercomputer which can operate or can transmit 100 million data per second. But even yes, the supercomputer can operate only some million data per second. So think about it, our brain is much greater than supercomputer. And the basic mechanism behind of it, quantum mechanics. All the signals are immediately transferred and all are immediately inspired, and suitable actions are immediately supplied by the brain to the record place. Musculoskeletal machines. In our musculoskeletal system, we have three types of simple machines, that is liver, wheel, axis, and pulley. We know obviously what is liver, a rigid rod rotates about a full frame in response to an applied force and a resistance load. So these topics you are studying from your school days, obviously you people are very familiar with this liver. So let us see how this liver helpful in our body while we are doing push-up, like physical exercise. Our knees, our chest, our legs, it bends and goes up and down. So we are using it simply liver mechanism. Similarly, nodding your head. Suppose if you are looking constantly, or you are traveling, or you are doing some physical work, you need to adjust your head. So at the time, you can rotate into 180 degree, not 360 degree. We are not permitted like that. You can view only 180 degree by the way of nodding. Here also we are having the liver principle. And similarly, lifting weight. While we are lifting, we follow the same liver principle. And similarly in walking. So in these four mechanism, liver principle or liver mechanism is highly helpful for us to run our life smoothly. And pulley. We know that pulley change the directions of applied force when we are running, when we are folding, or when we are walking. We are using the pulley function, pulley mechanism. And acoustic. Now you are hearing my voice because of acoustic. That is, it acts as a communication channel to propagate our information. You are hearing or we are enjoying the communication either from multimedia, just like cinema songs or classroom lecturing or whatever may be, we can hear. Same way, we can send the signals by the way of in the form of acoustics. So some other people can able to understand what we are trying to communicate with them. So acoustics, it plays major role in our daily life. So without acoustics, just imagine how we can communicate to others and how we don't need such a sophisticated developments in industry. And optics in the human body. Human vision is a complex process. From this figure, you can see that the image, that is a cycling man, that image is that undergoes multiple reflection. Before that, it has to cross iris, corona, pupil, lens. So here, all those phenomena are happen simultaneously without our permission. So acoustics is an important thing in our human life, and we have to thank the optics. And thermodynamics, heat and energy. Already I told you that
in our body we have some kind of our body maintains heat, energy and pressure. Without these three parameters, we are simply useless. So use of chemical potential energy stored internally to do work, and the stored energy is converted as a thermal energy, which you release as exhaustive heat. Our bodies always radiate the thermal energy, then only we can feel the temperature of the body. So when we are consuming food, the food is converted into energy by the chemical potential energy, and it is stored in the cell membrane, and it is taken by the blood circulation and reached to all the parts of the body. So our body maintain constant heat. So while the heat is transferred to one place to another place, energy also conducted so that we are all active. Suppose we may have heavy food, but we may feel some dullness, some boring, or something not pleasant way. That means what? We are having energy deficiency, or we are having excess energy. In that case, in these two extreme, our body cannot operate unpleasant way. And electricity, human body generates electricity from the elements in our body, like sodium, potassium, calcium and magnesium, have some specific electrical charges. So because of that, our electric signals are transferred from one place to another body, another places of the body, and almost all of our cells can use these charged elements to transmit our sense. And the flow of charge across the cell membrane generates electrical currents. Because of that only energy is conducted. Because of that only heat is conducted from one part of the body to another part. So we are healthy, and we can do all our works pleasantly. And here is one curiosity. You know that in our human body we are having multiple energies. That is the human heart's magnetic field can be measured in minutes. And similarly, the fetal development, the heart forms and start beating before the brain begins to develop. So these are all the important developments because of the sensing of electrical signals in your body. And now let me come to Newton point of view. So obviously we know that the scientific developments, especially in industry, that all developed by the Newton's law. Obviously everyone know Newton's first law and second law and third law. In the case of, let me read the inertia. It is a tendency of the body to resist any change in its existing state of rest or uniform motion. Let us look over the first figure. The small boy is riding a bike, and he facing some obstacle, a wall, which is stopping his travel. Immediately, he cannot stop the motion, so he is jumping out of the bike. Similarly, while we are driving car, we are using seat belt, which helps to retain our body constantly. Suppose if we are not wearing the seat belt, means when we are stopping our car, either needed place or by accident, automatically we will jump out of the car because of the Newton's first law. So everyone must wear seat belt while we are driving in four wheels. And also in the Newton's second law of motion, we know that Newton's second law is F is equal to ma. The greater the force, the greater the accelerations. How much force we are providing, that much accelerations we can expect. So if you are a small kid, it want to move its toy car, it is easy for it because it is weightless, so it can apply small amount of force, so it can easily move the toy cars. Suppose some person sitting in, for example, that boy's mother sitting in a toy car. Okay, if the child want to move the car, means he has to apply heavy force. Then only it can, the car can be moved. Similarly, for your bulk materials, what is your bulk matter? It means a real car. It can to pull it or to push it, we need high force. Two or three people's needed to move a car. And obviously, everyone is familiar with Newton's third law of motion. The best example is a rocket. For every action, there will be equal and opposite reaction. And because of this Newton's third law of motion, now we have reached the moon. Some scientists, they are reaching to Jupiter, and they are planning to reach all the planets to investigate what is there, what are the elements are there, whether human beings are able to survive there. Like the inventions are still going because of Newton's third law of motion. So we must thank Newton's for inventing these three laws. Without his this contribution, the entire technology has stuck in 17th century itself. And friction, we are walking. Without friction, we cannot walk constantly. We may fell down due to the lacking of frictions. So this is also familiar to you. You are studying from your school day itself. And flights. And here we are having aeronautical department students. And this is your branch. The Bernoulli principle is the fundamental principle of aerodynamics, which is the combination of four different forces: lift, weight, drag, and thrust. So how your bird is flying, that is the still mystics. And some people have understood, and afterwards we have developed flights. The total mechanic, simply we can say the Bernoulli principle. Sorry for interruptions. The total mechanical energy of the flowing fluid, comprising the energy associated with the fluid pressure, the gravitational potential energy of elevation, and the kinetic energy of fluid motion remains constant. Something complicated, but this was given by Bernoulli, so we must thank him. Without his contribution, now it is very much difficult for us to reach one corner of the earth to another corner of the earth. So we must thank to Bernoulli for inventing this this philosophy. And the vacuum cleaner. So dust is everywhere in home, working place, or outside, anywhere. So keeping cleanness in home is something difficult for us, isn't it? Especially women who are doing their works regularly in home, it is difficult for them to collect all the dust, all the unwanted things regularly, and put it in right place. So here we are having vacuum cleaner. It is also works based on the principle of Bernoulli principle, which states that the speed of air increase, the pressure decreases. Air will always flow from high pressure area to low pressure area. Obviously, we know that. So we can collect the dust particles which is available in low density area, low pressure area, so where we are having high pressure and vacuum. So it is easy for us to maintain dust free in a home, working place, or any place because of the vacuum cleaner. And the spacecraft, the main application, the philosophy is photoelectric effect, which was invented by Nobel Prize winner Albert Einstein. Because of this only, the electricity is developed, electric field is developed so much. Everyone may know that what is photoelectric effect? That is the action of electrons when electromagnetic radiation hits the metal surface. So this topic you have studied in plus two itself. It is a very interesting. which has many applications in nuclear physics, atomic physics, and in energy harvesting field. So we must thank to all for attention for inventing this photoelectric effect. Mainly in spacecraft it is employed, because in spacecraft we can provide certain amount of energy only from lifting. After reaching its destination, it has to produce the electric energy.
Hello, 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 hello. Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Thank you.
Hello, hello. Hello.
Hello.
Okay, bye.
Students, please be quiet. There is some audibility trouble with the resource person. He'll join us soon.
Ma'am, what problem? Hello.
Students, kindly wait for some time. Sir is joining now.
Okay, ma'am.
Hello, can you hear me? Madam, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Thank you. And the another application is ballpoint pen. Obviously, everyone is using ballpoint pen from our childhood. You can look at it. You are, yeah. In ballpoint pen, the main principle is gravity. The gravity forces the ink to go down and from the reservoir, and the tips, the ball in the tip. It starts to rotate the direction in which we are moving, so that we are writing implicitly in to understand the others. So the gravity, suppose if there is no the absence of gravity in a ballpoint pen, means it can't work. Generally, gravity is present everywhere when the gel is gel or ink is struck, at the time only the pen breaks down. And here are this some more applications of physics in real life. Water heater, which can be used to heat water. And another one is a fan. Now we are in a home or working place, in a car, everywhere we are using fan to get fresh air. And a TV, which is a very good invention, prove that we can communicate, we can transmit all the signals, all the information from one corner of the earth to another corner, lively and recorded emissions. And another one is spectacles. In previous decades, there was no spectacles, so the human beings suffered very much with their vision. Now, after inventing spectacles, now we can adjust the power of our glass, power of the glass, and also power of our eye, so we can view the object clearly with the help of spectacles. And steam iron box, it is the fantastic invention. When we are wake up, when we are planning to move outside for function or college, anytime we may want neat dress. For that we have to iron that. But a steam iron, it will provide the perfect ironing to our cloths. And batteries, energy storage device, which is the burning topic at presently across the world. So many scientists involved in this field to develop low cost and with a high efficiency batteries. And presently, we have reached sudden amount of capacity only. But some university researchers they are planning to develop nuclear battery, where once it is built, its lifetime is endless. So we can use it for unlimited time. We need not to recharge often. So once the phone is switched on, or laptop or electronic goods, equipments or appliances are manufactured, we have to inbuilt that nuclear battery. So it can run without interruption for long time. So these are all the fantastic invention contributed by philosophy of physics. And credit card and debit cards, where the basic principle is electromagnetic induction. You can see that in a chip card, in an ATM card, and also smart card, there will be small chip where all our informations are recorded electronically. So when we are swiping it, it produces electromagnetic induction. So the signal, the electric signals are connected to the computer, automatic teller machine. So it can understand what we need. So by the way of processing, we can get the money. So here also, we are having electromagnetic induction philosophy. And radar gun, we are having some limitations while we are driving in a car or bicycles. To regulate the speed of the vehicles, we have invented a radar gun. So without disturbing the traffic or without reaching the particular vehicles, we can measure how much speed they are traveling with the help of the radar gun. Here the basic principle is Doppler effect. Doppler effect refers to the change in the wave frequency during the relative motion between a wave source and its observer. So this is the basic principle of radar gun. And washing machine induction stove. This is also one of the marvelous invention, where we can wash our cloth in a short span of time, and also we can use it the bunch of cloths. And induction stove, where we can cook our food very short time at record place and record amount. And interestingly, mobile phone and Wi-Fi. Internets. Now we are all enjoying our communication through mobile phone, laptop. So without this invention, that is the wireless communication developed by EC department. So and we won't have the cell phone and also Wi-Fi and the internet the basic principle behind of it is wireless communication,
electromagnetic radiations,
and acoustics of buildings. Obviously, we are living in a home or in a working institution or college or anywhere, we must follow the acoustics of the building, that is the reverberation. All the sound should be echoed properly, then only we can enjoy the communication. It may be in concert hall or conference hall or classroom, that there should be proper and suitable reverberation, then only we can hear, we can enjoy the concert. And earthquake. We are all facing this this phenomenon oftenly across the globe. Now we are having so much of sophisticated instrument to predict earthquake well advanced, and we can make announcement to sit the peoples well advanced. The earthquake is also the important phenomenon. And in medical field, physics has contributed much level for scan our body. Ultrasound, it is used to scan the fetal development, growth in abdomen of our mother. So in each month, in each development of child, we can monitor. If there is any problem with the child, we can rectify from its growth. So in ultrasonics are highly helpful in scanning, and also CT scan. CT scan, computer tomography, it can scan the entire body and provide the minute details about our nerve systems, and MRI scan, X-rays. This is also highly helpful to scan our body, to find the flaws in the body. Superconducting machines. This topic already you may have studied in plus two, and in college life itself, in first semester, we are having this topic, superconducting magnetic material, which can conduct the electric signal at low temperature. So this is the fantastic phenomena. Even one of the professor from IISc, he developed and demonstrated superconductor at 0 degrees Celsius. And our Indian government expected Nobel Prize for this invention this year. But God only knows what happens there, and what went wrong with that. In famous magazine, it was discussed about his invention. But we missed it. But we are expecting next year, surely we will receive Nobel Award for our IISc professors. And what is the contribution of Indian scientists to our development of science? So far, we have discussed some topics. We have some phenomenon, some invention, which were developed by foreign country peoples, some of only our Indian scientists. I don't think that our Indian scientists have not done any contribution to science for development of science. Here we have some scientists. The first one is Sir C.V. Raman. We know that we have studied the Raman effect in plus two, spectroscopy, atomic spectroscopy, which was invented by Chandrasekhar Venkat Raman. While he was traveling in a ship, he invented this and he got Nobel Prize in 1930. He was a very important person for developing physics across our nation. And he visited many Indian universities and encouraged the young scholars to enter into physics, to do the fundamental research in molecular level. And another one is Homi J. Bhabha, who is the father of Indian nuclear power, and who proposed the our Indian government, we must establish nuclear power plant to demonstrate our powers, to meet the power deficiency in our life. And so like that he proposed, and the same person opposed to develop a nuclear bomb, because we Indian have to demonstrate peace to the world only, not the threatening by a nuclear bomb. But anyway, he initiated nuclear study in India. And another one is
Visvesraya, who was a notable Indian engineer. His birthday on 15th September every year. We are celebrating as Engineers Day. This year we celebrated in online platform. Next year we will celebrate his birthday in grand manner across the India and also worldwide. And he is the pioneer to establish many centralized universities, centralized research laboratories across the nation. His contribution is inevitable to develop our Indian science phenomenons. And another one scholar is Venkatraman Radhakrishnan, globally renowned space scientist known for his design and fabrication of ultralight aircraft. And afterwards, S.N. Bose, who is specialized in quantum mechanics, and he has collaboration with Albert Einstein, so that S.N. Bose and Albert Einstein did some research in statistics, especially in quantum mechanics. They proposed even a new theory, Bose-Einstein statistics, which is the backbone for nuclear reactions and also particle physics. And importantly, S.N. Bose applied continuously for Nobel Prize while he was alive. But God only knows what went wrong with that. But he was deserving person for Nobel Prize for inventing this Bose-Einstein statistics. And another one is Shaha. And Shah, he developed equations, which is the Shah equation, the basic tool for interpretation of spectra of stars. The stars are locating far away from our Earth. If you want to know the element, what are the element present in stars or any asteroids, simply we have to take the pictures. So from that, we can determine the ionization states of various elements making up the stars and the what happens and how it was built. Everything we can get the information from Shah equations. And another three scholars is J.C. Bose, who was the man of many field talent. And he was a polymath, physicist, biologist, and botanist, and archaeologist. And J.C. Bose, he has rich knowledge in this field. He contributed much level and demonstrated wireless communication for the first time. So now we are using Wi-Fi and we are using mobile phone. We are using we are enjoying television. These are all the development of our contribution by the J.C. Bose. And he also applied for Nobel Prize, but not granted to him. And another one is Vikram Sarabhai, father of India's space program, and established ISRO. We know that from ISRO has demonstrated wonderful achievements for past couple of decades. And important person, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. From the name itself, from the picture of this person, we can know that he is a famous person and successfully deployed the Rohini satellite in near Earth orbit. And one more thing, our proud moment is he was the 11th president of India. During his period, he visited across the India to meet young generation, to motivate them to enter into research for the development of India and to become superpower nation in 2020. But unexpectedly, he is not with us. But anyway, he implemented some seeds on our mind. Definitely, it will blooms. Our nation will become superpower nation very soon. And one of the very important characteristics of a student is to question. Let the student ask questions. This is the my goal, my motto. Whenever I'm lecturing, whenever I'm speaking with the students, I will speak less. I will ask my students to raise questions. Then only they can develop. Then only new philosophy are born which will be helpful for the development of our science and technology. So we must thank APJ Abdul Kalam. Here I am concluding. Problems are on the street. You need to work to discover them. So with this quote, I am concluding my my speech. If you have any questions, please arise me.
Students, now it's your time. If you have any basic questions, or if you want to know anything about the keywords or ketones you have heard from our physics, now you can raise the questions. Now our guest is ready to answer questions.
No questions.
You have another mode to raise your questions. You can put your questions in the chat box if you are not voluntarily willing to.
Okay, students are busy with their own philosophy. Whatever it may be, always keep questions in your mind. Then only you can invent some new things. As an engineer, you must spot some questions towards your teaching staff or any place. Simply don't mock up the phenomena and try to observe, try to have some answers in your mind. Thank you.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, please tell about acoustics, sir.
Acoustics. Acoustics is presenting in a building, in a classroom, everything. Simply, suppose if you are sitting in a room, it may be in a home or a classroom or in seminar hall, wherever, you can hear the voice clearly, isn't it? This is because of acoustics. It is the branch of physics which deals with the sounds only in building. We are having windows, sunsetting, and doors. Some openings are there. These are all the some parameters which will provide you best reverberation in your home, or in your classroom, or in your wherever you are. If there is any mismatch in reverberation, you cannot hear anything in your from the concert from the speakers. Suppose if you are going for cinema, in cinema theater, you can see some reverberation parameters. Whenever they are constructing the concert hall, they will follow certain parameters that you will study in second semester in first year. We are having one separate unit, acoustics, for civil students, and also common to all first year students. So you can get more information from that. Basically, acoustics is a phenomenon relevant to sound, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, student.
Thank you, sir.
Do anybody volunteer?